This is the Mark Milton Show with The Smash, with former Department of Justice Tax Division trial attorney Mark Milton and The Smash on 590 The Fan and 590thefan.com.
I should have been a cowboy. I should have learned to rope and ride. Wearing my six shooter, riding my pony on a cat and drive.
Yeehaw, this is the Mark Milton Show. With my partner in crime, The Smash, joining us from the Miller Furniture Studios, presented by STLTaxLawyer.com. Smash, how are we doing today?
I am fine. Can I just get into this Dr. Seuss thing real quick?
Sure.
So I'm looking at Dr. Seuss here. I thought, let me read a little bit of Dr. Seuss.
Sure. I think Smash narrating Dr. Seuss is actually, you could have like a whole, kids. You could be like ebooks.
Yeah, I could.
You got a little something for us?
Well, I'm just looking at Dr. Seuss. I asked a friend of mine to send me the words to Cat in the Hat and send me the words, but it says Marilyn Manson here right next to Cat in the Hat. Is this like a different wording?
I don't know what that is.
Cat in the Hat?
I don't know if I want to hear that.
That's hilarious. But I'm fine. How are you, sir?
I'm good.
I'm glad
you're gonna,
to see
you're not going
to
read us a little?
Well, I will in a moment here,
Gonna,
let's do some salutations.
Sure. Well, it's been a weird week, Dr. Seuss week. A lot of controversy over it.
March 2nd was the birthday of Dr. Seuss.
Correct.
All right.
And my son's school this week, it's Dr. Seuss week, which it's every day they do something different. They had green eggs and ham on Tuesday on Dr. Seuss's birthday.
Fantastic.
They had Wacky Wednesday. They got to dress up. He wore swim trunks over his uniform pants.
Yeah.
That was the best I could come up with.
That's good.
7:30 as we were scrambling to get out the door.
Right.
But this is insane. I mean, I guess this whole thing erupted because Dr. Seuss's birthday has always been National Read a Book Day or something
like that.
The president has historically read children's books at the White House, and they've always recognized Dr. Seuss. I know
always.
Michelle Obama had a big party with the Cat in the Hat, and they all wore the
Obamas love Dr. Seuss.
Right. So when I heard this issue or controversy, I'm like, how can there possibly be a controversy over Dr. Seuss? But sure enough, it's 2021, and the woke mob will find just about anything to get upset about, it seems like. And so Dr. Seuss apparently is racist, or there's quote racial overtones with his overtones. I don't even know. But I read Dr. Seuss to my
kids.
Whatever
the tone,
I'll continue to read Dr. Seuss to my kids. I think anyone that finds racism within Dr. Seuss books is insane.
Yeah.
It's insane.
Well, yeah, but one of the complaints about it is that it makes Asians look bad. Dr. Seuss makes Asians look bad. And by the way, it's not Dr. Seuss, like the god Zeus.
Seuss.
I saw a lady on YouTube was calling Dr. Seuss, and so I go, no, lady.
Well, here's the thing about that.
Seuss.
So, from my reading of Dr. Seuss books,
makes Asians
I don't
look
think
bad,
they
man.
Really. When I see the characters, he's not really ever portraying humans, right? Like the Whoville, the Whos. They're not really. They could be like aliens. They're kind of fictional characters. So, to say that he's depicting Asians or whoever in a negative light, it doesn't make any sense because he's not. I don't think he's saying in any of his books like, "Here's an Asian person."
Right.
Then I'm drawing. It's always sort of fictional. Yeah. It's sort of goofy.
But the drawings
it's out there.
Look like Asians.
It's always out there.
Yeah.
His like the Grinch. I mean, he kind of has a Billiken like. It kind of reminds me when I read Dr. Seuss.
Grinch
I think to myself, it's Dr. Seuss could have drawn the Billiken because it's sort of a fictitious, fictional character.
Yeah.
So it just blows my mind. Now, I do have a grievance, though, with the Cat in the Hat, and I'll tell you this story.
All right.
So we're upstairs. We put a bounce house in our basement during COVID. All right. One of those little,
been invited? No.
Oh, God. Here we go.
Just want to bounce.
Me and Smash almost came to blows during our pre-production, and it's carried over into the show. But
that will make for a more dynamic show.
That's
true. You don't understand. Dave, you've produced many, many shows. If there's a grievance between the two primary, shall we say, of the show, doesn't that make for a better show?
Oh, absolutely. The world
exactly
is
right.
Based on conflict, and in fact, with this whole cancel culture going on now, it's just gotten ridiculous because even
shut up, Dave!
See how angry he is?
Yeah.
See,
he's really fired up this morning.
I know, but I still think that we can't erase history, because if we erase history, how do we learn from it?
There you are.
Preach, Dave. Well, okay, that's one thing. But this, to me, is pure insanity. And we talk about race all the time, seemingly, in society right now. And when I look back at, you know, the tapes of Martin Luther King, I mean, the quote that everyone remembers that stands out is, people should be judged on the content of their character, not the color of their skin.
Exactly right.
So we continue to go down these rabbit holes of portraying people as a certain race, or giving favorite treatment to people of a certain race, or saying that people of a certain race are mistreated. It's like, why can't we just try to get past race? I mean, I thought that was the goal of the civil rights movement.
If we got past race, there would be no more conflict. If there's no more conflict, there's no more money to be had. Thus, the politics of it all, my man.
Can I tell my Dr. Seuss story real quick?
Oh, absolutely.
Go ahead, Dave. You seem like you got something on your...
Yeah, I do have a point. I would like to point out a prime example of how I think one outlet has handled it. Disney Plus, with The Muppet Show, they're not pulling any episodes, but there's a handful of episodes that, you know, dating back to when it came out, portrayed racial stereotypes that have later been determined to be politically incorrect.
So on The Muppets?
Exactly, with the Muppets or their guests. So what they do is, before those episodes, they put a disclaimer saying, this episode contains content that, while acceptable at the time, may contain content that is offensive nowadays, and here's an example of how we've evolved and what we can learn from.
Fine.
Very astute on Dave's part, but it makes me wonder, still watching the Muppets? Daggone it, Dave.
They're a classic.
Oh, yes, they're a classic. That's right.
So anyway, so we're upstairs, and I hear somebody yell out,
"Yes,
son of a bitch!" And it's my 5-year-old son, Frederick, yelled that out. And I went downstairs. I said, "Hey, man, what did you just say? Did you just say that? What I think I heard?" And he's like,
"He's 5 years old."
And I go, "Where'd you hear that?" And he goes, "The Cat in the Hat." So the Cat in the Hat movie with Mike Myers and Alec Baldwin. I don't know if you've watched that. It's pretty, rating is. It might even be PG-13.
Yeah.
But it's not really that appropriate for a little kid if they're saying that, obviously, and he's repeating that. Now, whether he heard me or Mama Milt say that at some point, and he's blaming Cat in the Hat, also possible.
Yeah. But you might have been that cat.
Those real-life Dr. Seuss movies are kind of creepy, like the Jim Carrey with the Grinch.
Oh, yeah, that. Yeah, that
Mike
was
Myers
creepy in a way.
With the Cat
Can
in
I
hat?
Give you the basic storyline of Cat in the Hat? And I'll show you where the racism comes in, just the racism.
Okay, sure.
All right. So what the deal is, two little kids, they look like they're under the age of 10. They're at home. It's a gloomy, rainy day. They ain't got nothing to do. And mom is gone, man.
Right.
All right? Dad, I don't know where dad is. And they're in the house by themselves, brother and sister. Well, all of a sudden comes pound, pound, pound on the door. They hear it again. Pound, pound, pound again, and the door busts open, all right? Nobody invite the door to open. The door busts open. What walks through the door? A big black cat in the hat, all right? So now the black is what the cancel culture is complaining about, because maybe the cat should have been one of these orange cats. Maybe it should have been one of these Siamese cats. Maybe it should have been one of them Egyptian cats or whatever it is. But that's the complaint, because now they're making it look like the Cat in the Hat broke into the house.
Oh, my
like
God.
Like oftentimes criminals will. This one happened to be a black cat, thus the racial overtones and or undertones to it.
I didn't even realize that's what they're saying.
That's
about
what the deal is, yeah.
That's insanity. That's insane. It really is. It's
but
crazy.
Why didn't Dr. Seuss paint the cat a different color?
Because he wasn't thinking about it. That shows you to me that he didn't. Black Cat in the Hat, it kind of rhymes, right? I mean, that's how he's known for rhyming. So I think Black Cat in the Hat flow than Orange Cat in the Hat or Yellow Cat in the Hat.
Yeah.
And he has other books with other, you know, one fish. Is one fish, two fish, three fish, four? That's a
Let me throw
Dr.
The next
Seuss
part
book.
Of it at. You ready?
Yeah, let's hear it.
One of the things that enhances the cat being of a racial stereotype, not only the blackness, but it's a feral cat, meaning it's just out of the neighborhood over there, and it just breaking into houses. No, I'm serious. That's the whole deal on this thing, because it's making a racial stereotype out of the Cat in the Hat.
Well, there's a professor that was on Fox News this week, and she gave her take on the Cat in the Hat controversy, because the Loudoun County schools in Virginia basically, I think, banned Dr. Seuss books from their schools. Dave, do you have that clip you can play for us?
Let's ask former professor, Dr. Carol Swain. Good morning to you, Dr. Swain.
Good morning.
Let's talk about Dr. Seuss, because Virginia's largest school district, it's been in the news a lot lately, Loudoun County Schools, they're having a problem with Dr. Seuss books. They say it's too controversial. Tell us more about this.
Well, I can tell you, I'm a Virginian, and I'm so ashamed of my state. I feel like I need to move back there and try to straighten things out. The social justice warriors see racism everywhere. There's no author who's white who's truly safe. So they see white supremacy and just about every kind of bias in Dr. Seuss. And you have to dig really hard and have a creative imagination to find racism in Dr. Seuss. I read it to my children. My grandchildren have read it. I mean, Dr. Seuss, really? There's no stopping point for these people. Seuss. They are totally insane. They're obsessed with race, and they are the true racists.
So this is what Loudoun County sent the press. As we become more culturally responsive and racially conscious, all building leaders should know that in the recent years, there has been research revealing racial undertones in the books written and the illustrations drawn by Dr. Seuss. What's your reaction?
Dr. Seuss was a person that promoted racial unity if they would take the time to study him. But they don't. They go after anyone and everyone. No one's safe. And if you look at some of the materials that they push, it is so racist. Their agenda is racist. And whether it's trying to have proportional representation in elite schools or removing Shakespeare from colleges and schools, what they're doing is dumbing down education. It hurts every student. Mm-hmm. We need to push back. Every parent, regardless of race, must push back.
See there? I mean, I think she gives them too much credit by saying it takes creativity to come up with. I think it takes a sick mind to look at a Dr. Seuss book and think, this is racist. This guy's racist. He shouldn't be celebrated, even though we've celebrated his work for 50 years. And what it's taught children in terms of not looking at people by the color of their skin.
Right.
I mean, I think that's a big, you know, she touched on it, that Dr. Seuss was known as trying to be someone who, you know, was a uniter and somebody who looked past race. And so to me, you have to look at the lessons that are taught through some of his books and look at the fact that, you know, the Grinch, while, you know, ugly and, you know, deplorable in a sense in his demeanor, ultimately you want to look past that and look at his heart and see that at the end, when he brings back all the gifts to Lucy Liu and the Who's, that he's everyone, you know, everyone has a soft spot. So that's how I look at it.
I'm tired
of
it. Heart.
I'm sick and tired of the woke mob trying to cancel things. And really, it's like a very small percentage of people that take all the air, take all the oxygen.
Who do you think, or what do you think, got through to President Biden that made him say, I'm not going to mention Dr. Seuss today, after decades upon decades of this presidential day signifying Dr. Seuss?
Well, that's what's so scary about Joe Biden. I don't think the Joe Biden of 10, 15 years ago would allow that to happen.
I don't think so either.
And that's where it's scary, because, like, I don't know who's calling the shots with him. Is it his chief of staff? Is it Kamala Harris?
Exactly.
Like, we just don't really know, and that's what makes the presidency right now somewhat frightening.
Yeah.
But we'll leave it at that. This has been the Mark Milton Show with the Smash Talking Cat in the Hat. You know, broadcasting from the Miller Furniture Studios.
Yes.
Presented by STLTaxLawyer.com. Be sure to check out Miller Furniture at one of their three locations, Belleville, Illinois, Lake St. Louis, and now in Ellisville on Manchester, 1.2 miles east of Clarkson Road. When we come back, we're going to have with us a special guest, Andy Newbold, First Bank Mortgage, talking mortgages, talking the home buyer's market right now. Look forward to having him on the show. We'll be right back.